Good evening, friends and family of Highland Valley United Methodist Church. We welcome you to this night's service of the Journey, which is Summer of Stewardship. And my name is Peggy Neighbors. I've been a member a long time here, but I'm serving now as your lay leader and a member of the finance team. We're so grateful that you are going to join us tonight as we get together and talk about two of our great ministries, the Infant Care Ministry and Watson Elementary School.
Good evening, Highland Valley. Welcome to our second Wednesday night of August's Summer of Stewardship. Before Margie Northcutt shares a bit about Infant Care Ministry and I highlight our Watson Elementary mission, I invite you to take a moment to think back on last Wednesday night. Did you learn something new about the Highland Valley Garden and Grounds? Did you decide what stewardship means to you? Have you pondered or prayed about your stewardship over this past week? Maybe you are encouraged to in your personal practice of stewardship. Are you being careful and responsible to manage all that our Creator has entrusted to you? These questions are important for each of us to ask, as our answers shed light on our relationship with God and others, even our relationship with ourselves. How we live out this critical piece of discipleship impacts our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness, wherever we might be. Isn't it exciting to know that we can grow in our faith through stewardship and in our stewardship through faith? I urge each of you to consider a few key questions as Peggy Neighbors reads this evening's scripture and Margie shares about infant care ministry and I speak about Watson Elementary mission. First, who do you most identify with in tonight's passage? Those wanting to know and asking questions about who is the greatest. Maybe you identify as one who is already childlike, or maybe you are one who welcomes the children. Now, once you establish with whom you most identify, then reread, study, and pray over these scriptures this upcoming week. Ask God to show you how to live out His word so that you might grow in your stewardship. In other words, ask Him to reveal how you might care for and manage your unique role in the missions and ministries of Highland Valley. More specifically, how might you be childlike in your prayer life for infant care ministry or Watson Elementary? Seek ways to welcome these children into your practice of stewardship. Maybe you can donate your time and talents within Infant Care Ministry or Watson Elementary Missions. Or maybe you could visit our website at hvumc.org and give to the funding of these life-changing ministries. Think about how exciting it would be to know your participation and support of these vital missions allows Highland Valley to reflect God's love and grace to the greater Little Rock community. Let's continue to be a congregation that knows Christ and shares Christ. My hope is that we will all look for new and different ways to become childlike as we participate in the missions and ministries of Highland Valley. My prayer is that we will welcome these precious children into the fabric of our stewardship. I look forward to seeing you next week when we delve into the exciting happenings of our Dirty Hands and Our House missions. Peggy, please bring us tonight's passage.
If you'd like to follow along this evening with a scripture reading, it comes from Matthew chapter 18, verses 1 through 5, and we can read it together. The first set of scripture, the greatest of the kingdom of heaven. At that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And he said, "Truly I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever takes the lowly position of this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me."
My name is Margie Northcutt, and I have the blessing of being the team leader for the infant care ministry here at Highland Valley, also known as ICM. If you hear those initials, that's us. We give baskets away to babies who are in need. This ministry started in 1994 with a call to the church with a mother whose house had burned down and she needed things for her newborn baby. We have 15 people that work in our ministry here at this church, and we have 18 agencies that we provide our baskets to every single month. We also do a project for UAMS by which we give them receiving blankets, and these are used as isolate covers to put over the covers so that the light won't be so intense. We give those every month. And this is what a basket looks like. This is everything that goes in the basket. They cost us about $50 to put them together, but this is what our agencies receive every single month.
Hi, my name's Georgia, and I've been shopping for ICM, and a lot of things for the babies that need care, and we've got lots of clothes and things for the infants.
Nowhere.
I couldn't find anything.
Okay.
So I'm going to try to see if I can find it online.
There you go. That'd be a good thing. DollarTree.com. Most of our things come from the Dollar Tree.
Yeah.
Most of them on the table. But thank you for shopping.
Thank you.
And bringing the bottles to us, and may the Lord keep you safe.
Yeah, you too. Thank you.
You probably want to know how you can help us. First of all, you can pray for this ministry that we are able to continue to provide these baskets to these agencies who have mothers that are in need. You can only imagine bringing the newborn baby home and not having the stuff that you need to give the baby a bath. You can help us by monetary donations and shopping. At this particular time, it's not a good time for us to be looking for items because there are none available. But we get most of our items from the Dollar Tree, so I'd like to tell you how you can help us. You can feed me for $8. You can put a diaper on me for $8. You can bathe me for $4. You can clothe me for $25. You can keep me warm for $3. And you can entertain me for $2. So you see, there's lots of opportunities for you to help us out in this ministry. We love what we do, all of us, and we have different jobs that we've had to adjust due to the COVID that we won't be together. This should be our blessing month, which is August, is when we get together, fellowship, and count our blessings. Thank you for your consideration for help for this ministry at our church.
Good evening. Did you know that for over 12 years, Highland Valley has been a partner in education with Watson Elementary in Southwest Little Rock, where often up to 98% of their students qualify for free or reduced lunches. In 2016, Highland Valley received the Volunteers in Public Service Partner in Education Award for the Little Rock School District. Through the years, Highland Valley has supported Watson in numerous ways. The Watson team, United Methodist Women, and other members of Highland Valley have blessed the sometimes over 600 students at Watson with book drives, basic undergarments like socks and underwear, coat drives, and many other items as requested and when needed. Highland Valley has also provided support to Watson Elementary families through our Highland Valley Food Pantry and Backpack Ministry. Highland Valley has even provided luncheons and supplies to teachers and staff members as often as possible. Every year, Highland Valley provides up to 2 new uniform shirts or dresses to all Watson children, working diligently to have the correct amount, size, and colors. This annual uniform mission is made possible through your generous gifts, which I must share often surpass our financial goal. And this uniform mission is also made possible by the volunteering of your time and energy to sort, load, and distribute uniforms to these precious students. As you all know, COVID-19 has profoundly changed so many aspects of our lives, including that of the beginning of the 2020-2021 school year for Watson Elementary. Your gifts have been received. We surpassed our goal, and we're ready to order uniforms. But we may need to change trajectory and provide supplies that might be more essential and needed than the uniforms. We are working diligently to share an update with you all as we visit with the principal and counselor at Watson. Hopefully, the update will come any day now. Every Christmas, Highland Valley presents all the students with a gift bag of goodies containing items like yummy holiday candy or age-appropriate toys or games, blankets, maybe a scarf or mittens or a hat. You get the idea. Some Christmases, Highland Valley has provided entire Watson families with Christmas presents via an angel tree. Maybe you've shopped for a few of these families in the past. This annual Christmas mission, like our annual uniform mission, is made possible through your generous gifts, which even around the holidays typically surpass our financial goal. It's also made possible through the volunteering of your time to sort, stuff, and distribute Christmas bags to the excited children the week prior to winter break. Like other missions and ministries at Highland Valley, Watson Elementary has enjoyed the leadership of many wonderful volunteers throughout the years. Carla Coleman has graciously led this charge for many years and has had the support of so many of you. If you're looking for a ministry to welcome children into your life of discipleship and to grow in your stewardship, I invite you to pray for Watson Elementary, for the students and the families and the teachers and the staff and the surrounding neighborhood. I invite you to serve and be present at Watson Elementary or at Highland Valley as we prepare uniforms or Christmas bags to take to Watson. I invite you to donate towards this mission. You can do that on our website at hvmc.org or drop your gift by the church or mail it in. And I invite you to be a witness of God's love and grace to this Southwest Little Rock Public Elementary School and its surrounding community. I promise you, when you make a difference in a child's heart, they in turn will make a difference in yours. The gratitude of Watson Elementary students through the years has been expressed through beautiful drawings, pieces of art, heartfelt thank you notes, or long letters, and even a few choir performances here at Highland Valley. This mission opportunity is one you will not want to miss. Thank you.
I'm a child of God. Yes, I Would you take this opportunity to bow with me for a word of prayer? Eternal God, we are so grateful for you and all of your graciousness towards us. We come, Lord, to lift up not just the membership of Highland Valley and the ministries that are taking place there, but to lift up all of your people in this entire world. And yet we certainly give you thanks for the infant ministry here at Highland Valley and for reaching out to one of our local elementary school, Watson Elementary. We pray, God, for this season of our lives and for our children, for our youth as they are preparing and making decisions and with their parents as to whether to attend school in person or to use some other means of educating themselves. Whatever that process might be, God, we pray that you be in the midst of all of it, that you bless the children, bless the parents, bless the grandparents, and bless this school year as we try to move forth with life. Guide us, direct us, and keep us. We pray these things in the precious name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you so much for joining us for the Journey Summer of Stewardship. Make sure you check back with us next week as we put our focus on the Dirty Hands Mission Project and our house. We'll see you then.